Chua. You can call me Ron. I am born on August 28.
I am 19 years old.
My course is BSECE or Electronics Engineering. 10 years from now, I see myself as a successful engineer in my field. My favorite colors are black, yellow, red, and white. My favorite hobbies are video editing, photo editing, and any kinds of editing field or digital arts. My comfort or stress food are sweets. Usually, I have a sweet tooth, so I like to eat ice cream, pillows, or any wafers or biscuits that we have at home. My favorite place would be somewhere breezy or with less people or less crowded places. My favorite people are my family, friends, and those close to my heart. My favorite songs are Imagination by Foster the People, Cool by Dua Lipa, and Way Back Into Love, which is from the movie musical lyrics. I don't know what my favorite books are, but usually I like to read stories that are based from movies to compare them. My pet peeves are people who argue without understanding what I said. It's like, you know. My favorite subjects are literature subjects or English subjects. I've been thinking
of running for so long. Different motives depending on the situation. So, as in general, I just try to stay positive. So, stay positive. Stay positive, boys. So, the thing that made me fall in love with journalism was when I saw how different school journalist teams were able to interpret their themes, topics, starting with the layouts, the style, the color palettes, the details of the fonts, lines, and more. Really inspired me to become a journalist. The first time I proudly said that I am a journalist was also actually the first time I entered a competition back in my junior high school days. I felt the belongingness because I really was devoted to what I was doing as a layout artist, as well as the cooperation and enjoyment I felt with my collab team, my school paper advisor, and the competition itself. I got in that same awe moment where, like the other people, they cannot believe that they were journalists themselves, and at that time it gave me joy and pride too. Honestly, because I'm more focused on the design parts than the content, I think that the topic that got me hooked until today was about uncovering fake news, since it usually fools me too, wherein after several experiences, I learned to be sharper in believing news. And taught myself how to further research and not to just go with misleading or unreliable publishers or pages, especially in social media. Kasi nga ang daming mga pan-tabloid pages sa social media na hindi natin napapansin agad na fake news pala to. Ganun. Parang minsan nagugoyo din ako dun. Ganun. So, it may be a common preference, but I adore Karen Davila amongst all since I subconsciously watch her documentaries that are from YouTube or any other social media na nakikita ko. Basta lagi ko kasi nakikita na parang documentary tapos by Karen Davila. So, siguro siya lang yung pinaka na reliable kung napapanood. Hindi ko sure. Well, being a journalist is really challenging, not only for the members who are writers, but every person who takes part in the publishing. Since papers or kung ano mang content are produced publicly, every publishing team or company will always receive different criticisms, maybe the content, the design, the perspective, or etc. That's why in journalism, multiple people work together in forming a content to reassure that every detail falls according to place as to avoid having misinterpretations as much as possible. See, it's a big damage dun sa reputation nila kapag nagbalitaan na ganito sila opinion ng fake news. Kaya may na small details lalo na sa mga masyadong critical. Personal lang kasi, it is not enough reason for me to back out of what I love to do. Kasi every profession naman has their own challenges, I think. You just have to have that certain reason that will keep motivating you to be in the field that you love. Ever since, I think the issue I am aware of is that journalists are usually being hushed, especially if the content somehow leads to telling everyone the truth, especially if it's the ugly truth. Since journalists are usually motivated by their or our freedom of expression or speech, different ranges of threat emerge from various people who do not see journalists in general eye to eye and prefers to keep them shut. As I have said nga kanina, journalists face intimidations and endless threats by different people, especially if you are a reputed one who unfolded or unfolds an ugly truth. Very easy to target by bigger people or those with power to do so. So it's a very risky job. Personally, I would not like to have it today. I'd prefer if it was all throughout for each of us, has the right of expression and freedom of speech, and without having anything to fear, people would be more raw and real of what they have in mind. They won't be scared to reveal what's truly happening under their perspective. But of course, it would be too much to ask for, so even having a day for impunity would really make a difference. And I think it provides enough time for the realness to come out. Yet, I still must say that not all journalists will have the same perspective as I do. So, a day like this would sometimes be a perfect opportunity for those with personal grudges or biased infos or, you know, paid propagandas to strike as well.